Hello everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. For the past year now, SpaceX has been working towards launching the very first orbital test flight of the Starship rocket. This is the most powerful rocket that has ever been built in the world, and it was built by Elon Musk's space company, SpaceX. The space company has performed quite a number of tests on the Starship, and most of them ended up in a large fireworks show. But now, with the successful launching and landing of the Starship, SpaceX is ready to take it to the next level. It is now ready to take the rocket into orbit. This will be a one-of-a-kind rocket launch. Of the tests that was carried out by the company, the highest jaunt was at 7.8 miles, which is about 12.5 kilometers into the Texas sky. However, SpaceX is planning on changing this record, but this is all dependent on a few factors. Everyone in the space industry is hopeful about this launch because it is one of a kind. This is the largest rocket in the world. It is also the rocket that Elon Musk is planning to use to launch people to Mars, which has been his main goal ever since the company started. However, there is a slight problem between NASA and SpaceX, and it might delay the launch. Before we go any further, please take a moment to leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos. So what's going on between NASA and SpaceX? As we all know, in preparation for the launch, SpaceX has been building a massive tower at the Kennedy Space Center's Complex 39A, which will be used to launch the 400-foot-tall Super Heavy and Starship rocket. However, NASA has brought about some issues and the agency has been stuck upon not granting SpaceX permission to fly its rocket. The agency has been given a condition that SpaceX has to assess the possible threats that are there to a nearby pad that is used to send astronauts and cargo to the International Space Station. The new tower by SpaceX is being built about 1,000 feet away from NASA's original 39A firing stand. This stand has been leased by SpaceX for the next 20 years as of 2014. This is the same pad where two of NASA's crewed Apollo missions and most of the agency's space shuttles have launched from. It is also the same pad that SpaceX uses to launch its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, which are either carrying satellites, cargo, or astronauts. However, since the Starship is not the same as other rockets, it requires a totally new infrastructure, which is why SpaceX is building this new tower. According to a report by Reuters recently, NASA managers are concerned about the possibility of a catastrophic failure on or just above the new Starship pad that could potentially damage the Falcon 9 launch infrastructure. If this infrastructure were to be damaged or destroyed, it would interrupt SpaceX astronaut flights to the International Space Station, which take place aboard Crew Dragon capsules. Kathy Loaders, NASA Space Operations Chief, told Reuters, "We all recognize that if you had an early failure like we did on one of the early SpaceX flights, it would be pretty devastating to 39A. When she said this, she was referring to an accident that happened in 2016. There was an on-pad explosion which ended up destroying a Falcon 9 and its payload. The payload consisted of communication satellites. Launch Pad 40 at the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station was also severely damaged in the process. But since the Starship is a whole different rocket, it takes this threat to a whole new level. Being the largest and most powerful launcher in the world, the Starship has managed to tip the scales at about 11 million pounds. Using the 33 methane-burning Raptor engines, the rocket will produce about 16 million pounds of thrust at liftoff, which is about twice that of NASA's Space Launch System Moon rocket. As for the upper stage of the Starship, which stands at about 160 feet tall, it will be powered by 6 Raptor engines. This is the part that will carry the astronauts, cargo, or both. SpaceX has managed to get a $2.9 billion contract from NASA to build a variant of the upper stage that will be used to land people on the moon in the agency's Artemis program. Since the 2016 accident, SpaceX has repaired and upgraded the Launch Complex 40. It has been operating a third Falcon 9 pad at the Vandenberg Space Force Base in California. However, neither of these facilities is equipped to launch Crew Dragon astronaut ferry ships. Boeing's Starliner capsule, which is expected to be launched from a crew-ready pad at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, has not yet been certified for operational use. In addition to this, NASA considers Complex 39A critical to ongoing space station operations. Do you think that NASA's move to deny SpaceX permission to launch the Starship from the launch pad 39A is a good one or a bad one? Let us know in the comment section below. Responding to a query by CBS News, NASA confirms the claims from the Reuters story. The agency said on Thursday, June 23rd, that SpaceX has not yet been granted permission to launch the Starship from the 39A complex. NASA's statement said, in the coming weeks, NASA and SpaceX will conduct a thorough review to ensure safe operations at the pad and assess redundant launch capabilities for NASA crewed and cargo missions to the International Space Station. As part of the review, NASA and SpaceX are assessing all options available, including the development of a crew transportation capability at Space Launch Complex 40 on Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida. Pad 40 does not have any towers at the moment, so if SpaceX wanted to use it, they would have to make some massive modifications and upgrades to add access to a Crew Dragon that would be on top of a Falcon 9. This would enable last-minute cargo additions as well as provide an emergency escape capability. As for the huge Starship and Super Heavy complex, SpaceX has built a pad and tower in Boca Chica, Texas. This is where the company is planning to launch the rocket for the first orbital test flight soon. It is also where the company will be carrying out its other orbital test flights. The company is currently working to build a second Starship pad at 39A, and it is in the process of stacking massive open lattice segments, one on top of the other, with the help of a large crane. The first of the 8 segments of the tower was transported to the complex about 2 weeks ago, while the second one was transported and installed sometime last week. According to NASA, the agency is responsible for ensuring SpaceX remains compliant with the requirements of the property agreement for the use of Launch Complex 39A. The agency said, these requirements include those related to construction, safety, and environmental conditions. At this time, NASA has only provided approval to build. Additional review for hazards, operational impacts, and supportability will be required prior to launch. According to the regulations, any launch that originates from U.S. soil has to acquire a license from the Federal Aviation Administration, the FAA. This means that SpaceX will have to get a license from the FAA before they can continue to launch the Starship. Before SpaceX can be given a license by the FAA, they will have to complete about 75 actions to reduce environmental effects of flying the massive rocket. However, the regulators have recently confirmed that they found no significant impacts. Because of this, SpaceX is now a step closer to receiving a launch license. SpaceX is required to take actions to mitigate environmental impacts from its proposed plan to launch the Starship Super Heavy vehicle from Boca Chica, Texas. The decision means that SpaceX will have to do some work to make sure that they have reduced the possible damage to the environment at the Boca Chica site, which is located close to state parks and a wildlife refuge on the South Texas coast, east of Brownsville. But even though it may somehow make the whole process longer, SpaceX now has a roadmap to clear a major regulatory hurdle that has been in the way of commencing full-scale test flights on the massive rocket. SpaceX is about to change how we see the space industry. They have been working towards launching the largest rocket in the world, and they might just do it in the near future, maybe even a month from now. However, before that, the company will have to play by NASA's rules if they want the launch to be successful. Do you think NASA is justified in preventing SpaceX from launching the Starship from Pad 39A? Feel free to let us know now in the comment section below. Also, before you go, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, technology, and so much more. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.